Hello everybody, so this is me again, Roberto. I just came up with a new mnemonic that I would like to share with you, and as always, this is dedicated to Baron Rux. I hope you enjoy it. So this is an integration between the physiology of urination and pharmacology. So let's start by saying that the parasympathetic nervous system, through the cholinergic receptors, stimulates urination. In the other hand, the sympathetic nervous system, through the adrenergic receptors, specifically the alpha receptors, inhibits urination. So I'm going to take the C and the A, and I'm going to draw urinary system. So here we can see our bladder, which has cholinergic receptors in the detrusor muscle. And here we can see our urinary sphincter, which is controlled by alpha receptors. So if we want to increase urination, such in the case of a post-op bladder that does not want to contract properly, we can use a cholinergic agonist such as bethanecol. Bethanecol is going to cause contraction of the bladder through the cholinergic receptors. In the other hand, if we want to decrease urination, such in a hypertonic bladder which contracts too much, we can use oxybutynin, which I spell oxybutynin, the X inhibiting the contractions. In the other hand, we can also increase urination through the alpha receptors by blocking these receptors in the sphincter. Some examples of these drugs are tansulosin and prazosin, which are going to increase urination by inhibiting the alpha receptors. A great scenario for the step in which these drugs can be used is a patient with present with BPH as well as hypertension. Here, our first choice is going to be the Zosyn drugs because they treat both conditions at the same time, and the step really likes that. So I hope you like it and I hope you learn. Have a good day.